This little baby was bobbing his head to Let's Go Crazy. The real music was playing in the background. Mother was just taping it. I don't know if whoever has kids in here, we know how, you know, make the cute little videos. I do it all the time with my kids. And she put it up on YouTube. Well, Universal, who is basically the gatekeeper for Prince, went to YouTube and said, we want to take it down. We want to take this down because it's clearly our copyrighted material. And they did a takedown notice, a DMC, a Digital Millennium Act takedown notice. And YouTube took it down. It happens all the time. I do them every day. I mean, there's always content up there that you pull down. Well, baby's mom sued, and she said, sure, it's copyrighted material, but I'm claiming fair use because I was just making, no one's going to believe that this is going to interfere with Prince's revenues. The court's saying Universal should have had a documented process to go through this before they issue a takedown notice. And if it comes out that it seems like it's fair use, they should not have issued that takedown notice. That's the whole procedure that's going to be in place now. I always think that you should always use your best effort to clear everything. Don't depend on fair use to save you. It's more of an afterthought, really, when you're in the cutting room and you're like, okay, can we get away with fair use or do we need to get a license? And you're going to fall on the side probably of it's fair use, but you need to analyze your liability of whether someone's going to come after you or not. So that's just the disclaimer of any lawyer. Every lawyer is going to say clear everything. I'm a very big advocate that the Copyright Act needs to be scrapped and redone because it's been, you know, 1978 is the newest act, you know, and it's pieced together. I'm kind of a radical attorney because I just don't see peace. I don't see just tweaking here and there to match the digital age versus what we had back in 1970s. It just doesn't seem like it's going to work. And a lot of the things that are coming out from the 78 Act, like their termination rights and all these things that are coming into play now, they just don't fit our current situation. Because up until then, like if you ever want to use Happy Birthday, you have to get a license from Warner Brothers. And that's what the courts found. Well, some producers said that was wrong. They filed a claim and wanted a declaration of that Happy Birthday was in the public domain. And the court found that Warner Brothers wasn't the owner because the rights weren't actually transferred to them properly. So they didn't find that Happy Birthday is in the public domain yet. That's still going on. They're trying to determine, because there's a third party that comes out and says, oh no, we own the rights. We received it from the original writers. So now it's in limbo. But I'm starting to see Happy Birthday played a lot, so I think people are less worried about what's going to happen. But technically, it's not in the public domain yet, and it's not owned by Warner Brothers. Those are two things we do know. The court's going to have to determine whether it's owned by this third party who came out. And if they find that it's in the public domain, this third party doesn't own it, then, you know, free for all. We can all use Happy Birthday. A lot of times when you go to clear, you always try to say, well, look, we're going to give you, you know, a promotion. I'm going to give you credit. You know, you always work that angle first. But if it doesn't work, then you have to clear it. People always ask me, why do you do all this paperwork for my little film? And I'm like, it's not about you and between you and the person you're doing the agreement with. It's about the third person so they can make sure that they don't get sued if they put out your film. Once you have the insurance will require like a fair use analysis if you're saying that something is fair use. And a lot more blurring goes on in documentaries because, you know, you kind of blur out those problemed areas. Whereas when you're shooting, you can reshoot different angles or you can monitor what people are wearing, you can monitor the labels. A lot of people get twisted with this because newsworthy clips can be used by news organizations. But that doesn't mean that a third party in a documentary can use that clip without getting clearance. And a lot of people think, okay, it's fair use because it's a news clip. It doesn't apply like that. If you're a local news organization or a channel, you can pull clips from other people and it will be fair use. But if you're doing a documentary, you have to get a clip for that license, for that use. I've seen people try to say, okay, we're very fair use, but we want to be safe. They go to the copyright owner And the owner says, you know, no, give me $10,000. And they're like, oh, no, never mind. We'll just claim fair use. They always stop, that they'll come out the woodwork and definitely stop your distribution. Thank you. We'll be right back.